Good morning and thanks for joining us. I'm Veronica Brandon Miller and this is Goodwill Minnesota's Good News, where we share with you the good that is happening in our community. And this past week, we've heard so many sad stories on the news. So I hope you enjoy this show where we share the good news. And there is, like I said, so much good. And I want to remind everyone, since it's April, April is National Child Abuse Prevention Month, and that's why I'm wearing blue. And also, it is National Autism Awareness Month, and it's also National Parkinson's Awareness Month. But we are also celebrating National Volunteer Appreciation Month. And for everyone out there who donates their time to a special cause, we applaud you and thank you for everything you do. Organizations like Goodwill and the Pines and Neuro Challenge couldn't do what they do without the special appreciation and support from our volunteers. So again, if you have an hour of your time, I encourage you to go out, find a passion and support that cause. So with that, why don't we just dive right into good news. Today's show, we have three fabulous people. We have David Sylvester, the president and CEO of the Pines, which we're going to hear some great things about that. We also have one of my favorite friends, Estelle Crawford, who is the president of the Pines Foundation, which I know a lot about, and we can talk about that too. And then also Carisa, I love this name, Campanella. It sounds so, so sweet, who is serving as the South County Care Advisor for Neuro Challenge, and you just had a fabulous event, so I can't wait to talk about that also.
Thank you.
So with the show, why don't we start with David, and we'll go right into the beautiful ladies.
Fabulous. I think I'm outnumbered, aren't I? So Pines of Sarasota has been around for 68 years, serving the needs of the community. We serve on a 25-acre post-acute care campus with skilled nursing facility, assisted living. We have two rehabilitation centers. We have an education institute that markets training videos around the world. We're in 32 countries now.
Wow.
We have child daycare. We have a fabulous foundation that Estelle is going to talk about. And we have additional property that we're excited to look into what we intend to develop over there. But if I may, I'd really like to focus on one of our new initiatives, which is called Ready and Steady, a plan for better balance. If you're over 65 years of age, one in three people will fall. Falls are the leading cause of injuries, fatal as well as non-fatal. And 10 years ago, the number one reason to be in the emergency room was a car accident. Today, it's a fall. Mm. So we offer a free screening to the public, free screening to determine your level of balance. And if it's a small improvement needed, you can exercise, go to the Y, or those kinds of things. If you have higher requirements, then you come back and receive physical and occupational therapy in order to improve your balance. Everyone can benefit from it. The number to call for a free balance assessment is 941-552-1882.
Well, for 10 years of my life, I worked for the National Safety Council, and part of the information was falls, and this is way back in the early 90s. So the fact that it's still the number one leading cause of injury and death, it's amazing that this is still going on. And I applaud the Pines for actually stepping up. And I love the name.
Ready and Steady.
Ready and Steady.
It really is a public service, and it's something you can do to improve yourself. Sarasota is a community of well and fit individuals, including elders, and here's something that folks can do for themselves to improve their quality of life.
Wow, and you do so much at the Pines. So I remember reading, it was called the Welfare House.
The Sarasota Welfare Home, that's correct. And that was how it was founded 68 years ago. We've grown into that and more. In fact, we take care of individuals who have the resources to stay anywhere that they would like to stay. They've stayed with us. They've had a very good experience. Some have come back as philanthropists and really helped spearhead some of our programs. And we just are so thankful and appreciative for the community support, very much like Goodwill. It's a community interaction, and that is where the synergy comes from.
Yeah, and you're right. What's the best thing is they actually are experiencing firsthand the amazing care they receive. So yeah, you have the whole scale. So what went from such a need, and it was started through
the Kiwanis Club. Yes.
That's right. I love Kiwanis. I'm a Rotarian, but we do play well together.
I was a Rotarian, now I'm a Kiwanis, so I can relate.
There you go. And we know a few, we have similar donors that actually go there. And my father recently just went through outpatient care.
Okay.
Therapy. Mm-hmm. Some
rehab.
Sort of rehab.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Sure. Sure.
So yeah, he loves it. He is one of your number one fans, and so now we got to make him a donor. Thanks, Dad. Anyway. but what else is happening? Because I know you're doing something special with the Patterson Foundation.
Yes. Very nice lead-in. Thank you so
okay.
much. So our Education Institute, about a year ago now, was in a competitive process to have access to consultants who work for an organization by the name of No Margin, No Mission. They focus on earned revenue for nonprofits. And we were successful in working through the process so that we were one that was chosen to receive these funds, and have utilized them to develop a new website and to do some marketing and build a little office at Pines. We have a lot going on, so we don't have a lot of extra space. And we hired a new individual as a customer service representative. So we've really prepared an 88-page business plan, very comprehensive, very targeted, has measurable goals, and we're now in the implementation phase. So we're very excited about it. We provide education to individuals living with or taking care of folks with dementia. And there are many kinds of dementia and many different levels. And there are many things you can do to focus on the positives of dementia. In fact, Tipa Snow, who is our expert that we utilize, has a program called GEMS. And each stage of dementia is assigned a GEM, and that points to the positive characteristics that the individuals can still function, and you focus on the positive.
Oh, I wish that was around. My mother, you remember,
yes.
Had dementia. Oh. And just that educational piece for the family is so vital. So again, what the Pines is doing is cutting edge, amazing, and so needed.
Yes.
But what I love too is that you're diversifying your revenue. So
absolutely.
For you to be able to grow, and everything I'm reading is everybody is moving down to Florida. So the Pines is going to expand.
Absolutely.
So that's great that you're doing this component. How can someone purchase this?
So go to the website, pinesofsarasota.org, and there will be a link to the Education Institute. Now, their brand new shiny website, it's not up and running yet. It's in beta testing, but it's very close. And there are streaming opportunities available as well, but very targeted and appropriate education, very unique and very effective. So we're proud to do so.
Oh, wow. And I'm seeing Cliff Rawls.
Ah.
Was he a patient or no?
He is associated with a resident at Pines.
Oh, see, that's wonderful.
And yeah. And a great supporter.
And that says a lot, because when you're recommending the Pines, that's the best form of advertising.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Absolutely. So, well, I think it's wonderful what you're doing. And again, let's say the website one more time, because I want people to definitely utilize this
Terrific.
Service.
So it's pinesofsarasota.org.
So go straight into it.
Absolutely.
And, you know, somehow I'm going to tie this into Estelle, but I also want to remind everyone that you have a thrift store.
We do. We have two.
And that helps also with the diversified revenue.
Absolutely. And it's amazing. It's such a resource. It's amazing how many times we have something mm-hmm. going on in the operation and we say, what if we had a, oh, we just go to the thrift store and get one. So, and they're fun. I shop there often myself.
Uh-huh. And again, if you're cleaning out your closet, yes, thank you for supporting Goodwill, but also there are so many other organizations that you can support, like the Pines, and that revenue helps them achieve their goals and expand. So absolutely. Keep that in mind. And with the Pines, we were talking about how fabulous this facility is. We do have to have a subsidiary to help support, and that's where we have the Pines Foundation. Mm-hmm. And Estelle Crawford, how long have you been with the Pines?
A decade.
Wow. Wow.
I'm saying wow myself, you know. time really runs by when you're having so much fun, and what I do, it's such an honor.
And you do a fabulous job.
Thank you. Well, we kind of have a mutual admiration society. You know?
Yeah, we could have this love fest. You're great. No, you're great. So let's talk about the Pines Foundation okay. and how you support the Pines.
Sure, it's a pleasure. Three main areas. First of all, capital needs. So let's remember that we have residents who call Pines their home. So it's essential that not only is Pines beautiful and clean, but it's also, it's really a great place to live. And one of the most exciting, the recent capital need that we've just fulfilled is our beautiful new beauty shop. It's going to have a ribbon cutting on, yes, on May 6th. Oh. It's the Ann Goldstein Beauty Salon. And you know how we all feel mm-hmm. when we look so good, right? Mm-hmm. Manzer Rehabilitation Center, there are many areas that the capital needs. And it's only through donors that happens. Another area of activities and programs. So whether it's the educational programs or the myriad of activities that are offered for our residents, because it's essential that this is a place, and it always has been a place to really live, you know, to fulfill mm-hmm. your potential at whatever age. And I'll tell you, we have residents who are still painting. I have a wonderful story very quickly of a resident who showed me her paintings and said, Estelle, you can share it with your board, but if they want it, $15.
Aww.
We got
great.
It.
Okay.
And a little more. Aww. So, but what I'm saying is they're excited and they're wonderful. And I'm astounded at the age. You know, these are our grandmothers and grandfathers, mm-hmm. and they're coming in, what about in the late 80s? Mm-hmm. We have a family member who called me and she said, I'm coming in, Estelle, to see my mom. Will you be there? She loves you. And that family member's 80. Mm. Mom's 103.
Oh, wow. God bless.
So,
wow.
So that's what happens at Pines. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And finally, the last broad area is endowment. It is essential that Pines continues to be there for mm-hmm. the moms and dads and grandparents of tomorrow. Mm. You know, so.
Oh, absolutely.
Yes, so that's what we do.
So everyone who's watching, I'm inviting you on a tour. Like I said, the Pines Foundation is dear to my heart. I used to serve on the board.
Yes.
And it's something I truly believe in. So if you just want to take a tour and just see this amazing facility, David was talking about how they have the child care. So you're seeing a whole different generation growing. Yeah. At the Pines, and it's beautiful. It is beautiful, and I am so excited about the beauty salon.
I will take you too when you come in. It's such a happy place.
You're looking at my hair. Next week I will have different highlights, I'm just saying. But it is great, and it is a great facility, and very warm and caring. When you need to expand,
right.
you need funds. And
you know, Veronica, one of the things that have not changed in all these years is our mission to ensure that even those who've outlived their financial resources still will call Pines home.
Mm-hmm.
So that's very special.
Yes. So, any events coming up? Because that's another way that you're generating revenue.
Absolutely. You know, our major event is in November. We do one annual Wit and Wisdom of Aging. We're very, very fortunate because we've been voted as the best special event now. This is for 4 years in a row.
Awesome.
And this is a community of special events.
Oh, that is
fabulous.
And
by the way, our fabulous finds thrift shop has also received awards.
Oh, that's wonderful.
I just have to plug that in too. So we're thrilled with that. This year we have Jerry Aaron as a co-chair and Jane Hunter. So
good.
Names that I'll you know, identify. But we also have some smaller events that really are thank yous to our donors. We recently had one at the Field Club, and it was at that event that we were told of a $100,000 challenge.
Excellent.
It's still going on. $100,000.
So encourage people to...
I encourage people to avail themselves of being able to leverage their donation.
Right. And going back to the endowment, when an organization is able to live off the endowment for their administrative costs, so every additional money that is raised goes towards pure mission and growth.
That's right.
That is so important.
That's right.
So the fact that you have this match is fabulous.
Yes, I think so too.
Keep that in mind for your, you know, what should I get my husband for, you know, his birthday? Why not make a donation in his name?
Because he doesn't need another necktie.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Oh, that's awesome. And back to Wit and Wisdom, which came out of
the Beauty of Aging.
Beauty of Aging, okay. Which I loved when I was helping you guys. But it is so much fun. It is a great event. You have great people coming.
Yes.
So besides people donating cash, money, stock, whatever,
real estate,
whatever you want. What about, do you need volunteers?
We absolutely, like every organization, we certainly do need volunteers. And I will tell you, we are blessed to have a wonderful director of volunteers. Ivy's having actually a thank you event coming up, and it's going to be a hoedown.
Oh, a hoedown. That's a fun way
so
of doing it.
So she's creative, very, very creative, and we are so we couldn't do this job without it. So our residents count on it, and it brings us a smile to all of our faces.
And like I said at the beginning, volunteers are such a...
Lifeblood
of an organization.
Absolutely.
And April is, well, you should do it all year long, but April is National Volunteer Appreciation Month, so at least this month, make sure that you send out a donation or a letter and thanking them for everything that they do to support your organization. So let's talk about your website so people can sign up to volunteer, buy tickets for your events, and just make an outright donation.
It's just www.pinesofsarasota.org. You'll find the foundation, you'll find volunteers, you'll find everything you need on that website.
Yes. You do have a nice website.
Thank you.
And I love your new logo.
Yes. We have a great marketing director who's created it.
Yes. She's fabulous. And it's just lively, just like the whole campus. And again, I'm going to have everyone call David or Estelle for a personal tour because you will be amazed. It's not what you normally would expect, but it is fabulous. And let's talk about fabulous on another aspect. I just went to an event last week for the Neuro Challenge, and it's one of the best events out there.
Oh, thank you.
So, Carisa, why don't we talk about the Neuro Challenge?
Thank you. Thank you, Veronica. It's nice to be here with David and Estelle. Nice to hear your story. And I have toured the campus, by the way, and it is gorgeous. So I do recommend people go for a tour. Neuro Challenge Foundation for Parkinson's, we're a nonprofit organization located here in Sarasota. Our mission is very basic. We're here to improve the quality of life of people with Parkinson's and their caregivers. And we do that in three ways. One is through ongoing educational groups with local and national thought leaders. We do individualized care advising, where we help people with Parkinson's find resources in the community that will help them live better. And we have ongoing monthly support groups for people with Parkinson's and their care partners and their families to help them cope with the disease. All of this combined, we feel, is a better approach to Parkinson's, and we're very committed to it. So,
absolutely.
Yeah.
And how long has it been around?
So NeuroChallenge was established in 2008 by Doreen Sutherland, who had a vision that people with Parkinson's, when they got diagnosed and got their medication script, really needed a roadmap and really needed support to help them cope with the changes of this that come with this disease, like muscle stiffness and challenges with balance. Mm-hmm. Dementia sometimes accompanies it. So they really needed support and guidance on how to live well with these symptoms. And that's why NeuroChallenge was established. And in that time, we have grown to cover Bradenton down to Northport, even into Charlotte counties. We estimate there's about 9,000 people in our area with Parkinson's. And some of the people that you're seeing on the screen now are members of our community, living well, exercising, participating in local resources, and just being an example for all of us, really.
So there's no cure for Parkinson's.
Correct. There's no cure currently. There are medications to help manage the symptoms, mm-hmm. like tremor and muscle stiffness. What many people don't know is that exercise is a treatment modality that is as important as medication. So at NeuroChallenge, we work hard to work with local organizations like HealthFit, the YMCA, the Northport Yoga Center, to help them develop programs to meet the exercise needs of our Parkinson's community. And the ones that do exercise do experience a better quality of life. There's just no doubt about it, as we all do when mm-hmm. we exercise.
And that's why it's so important to have the NeuroChallenge for Parkinson's Foundation. Before Doreen, what did people do? I mean, it makes you just wonder, because there are so many different kinds of services, but to compile them, because when
right.
someone calls and says, hey, my mother, my father, my husband, mm-hmm. whatever, I need help.
Right.
And that's why we love you.
Thank you. and we feel that we're able to direct them towards that help. Myself and my colleague Jennifer Williams, who's the care advisor for Sarasota County, we work in partnership with all these local agencies like the Pines of Sarasota, referring to the Ready and Steady Balance program is very helpful for our community. We have formed the relationships. We know where to refer people. We've vetted all these local resources. I'm not just going to refer you to anybody unless I've met them and seen the program with my own eyes, and I know it's reputable. We really try to maintain a very high quality and high standard of care for our community. And the best part is when we see our community bond with one another through these avenues and form their own friendships, and they go to lunch, and it's wonderful to see,
well,
truly.
I love what you do, and I'm grateful that Goodwill is able to partner with you, and we brought yoga.
Yes, you
to
have
our
actually the Goodwill. Yes, the Goodwill Karma Yoga program that takes place at the Northport Yoga Center is a Goodwill sponsored program. Absolutely, and you've always been a partner of ours, and we're happy to be an ambassador of Goodwill. And it's just great to have all this positive community energy around the people with Parkinson's that we serve. So absolutely.
So on that subject, what can the community do for Parkinson's Awareness Month?
So what you can do is maybe attend one of our local educational programs. We actually have two coming up on April 11th at the Venice Chamber of Commerce. We're featuring Dr. Carl Klecki, who is a urologist who's going to be speaking on bladder issues and Parkinson's. And on May 6th, we have Dr. Jody Abrams, who's a neuro-ophthalmologist who's going to be speaking on vision issues and Parkinson's. We want our community to know that people with Parkinson's have special challenges, but they are still vibrant, active members of the community. If you see somebody who's moving slowly or their hand is shaking, you know, treat them like everybody else. Mm-hmm. They're out there. They're living their life. They understand what you're saying. They may have a facial mask because their facial muscles don't move as well, but they're fully comprehending what you're saying, and we're just so grateful that they're out there enjoying their life in Sarasota like everyone else.
And start the conversation.
Oh, absolutely.
Too.
Sure.
Because just like you said, it happens. And, you know, with the NeuroChallenge, you can provide resources how to have a better life managing
Correct.
With Parkinson's. But have that open discussion that, you know, what can I do? Treat them just like you normally would.
Absolutely. And if people want to learn more about Parkinson's, we've actually developed this resource guide. It's been written by people on our staff and our medical director, who is Dr. Dean Sutherland, by the way. He's an outstanding medical director. And the resource guide is filled with information on what Parkinson's looks like, how to cope with it, specialized physical therapy programs. It's really your how-to guide for living with Parkinson's. And it's for everybody, anyone who wants to learn about it or people living with it. And you can get a free copy of this by calling our office at 941-926-6413.
And like I said last week, you had an awesome event, and you
did. Thank you for coming.
One of my dear friends, Kelly Lavin.
Absolutely. So we honored Kelly Lavin, who has been a long-term supporter. She's the publisher of Sarasota Magazine. Her mother actually had Parkinson's, and she became very involved with our foundation, along with Doreen Sutherland, at its inception. So with Kelly and Doreen together as a unified force, they helped get this little foundling organization off the ground, and since then it's just grown to serve so many. So we're so grateful to Kelly and Doreen for starting it. And yes, our gala was a lot of fun. It was well attended. We had a DJ, and we promoted a lot of awareness. So thank you for your partnership in that as well.
So how else can someone...
Next time you guys have to come.
Oh, yes. Yes. It was definitely a great event. How can the community help support you?
So we are an organization that runs strictly on donations. We get some local community grants, which we appreciate, but we don't get any government support or state support. We run strictly on donations, and we're very blessed to have very generous donors in the community. So you can make a donation to us by going to our website at neurochallenge.org. You can help us in our office by volunteering to do some administrative work. We always can use our volunteers. So for Volunteer Awareness Month, if anyone's looking for an opportunity. And then they can just, you know, call us to learn more about Parkinson's and what they can do to be helpful to people with Parkinson's in our community.
Oh, you know, last week, and I talk a lot about corporate social responsibility and cause marketing. And this is a great way for an organization or company, even families, to get together and do a special fundraiser for awareness for Parkinson's. And contact Carisa, contact the Neuro Challenge, and do something different. And I'm going to hope that someone responds and will do a percentage off and for Parkinson's awareness or... You know what I'm talking
Thank
about.
Thank you. That
I
would
just
be
want
wonderful.
Someone to do that.
Yeah, we've actually had certain sponsors in the community do that for us. Talbot's, when we did our Cause for Fashion event, where we have people with Parkinson's actually model clothing. Talbot's offered a discount to people that attended that event the next day. Right. So we do have wonderful corporate partnerships as well, and sponsors that want to help our community as well.
Wow.
So, yeah, it's very good.
And Goodwill will continue to help.
Oh, gosh, you guys have been amazing.
You know,
wonderful.
Spread the awareness, because we are a great community, and we take care of each other, and that's why I moved here, and I love... It was the best thing I did was move down here.
I think all of us here have hearts of service. You know, we're all here to serve our community. We're all here to help make Sarasota a more unified place, a positive place. Like you said, Veronica, there's so much negativity in the news. Mm-hmm. This is one of the few shows I watch because I like to live in my own bliss bubble. but it's really good to see what good things go on in our community at a local level. We all are so fortunate to live here. It's the best place in America, I think. But I'm biased. I've been here 12 years, so.
Absolutely. So anything else anybody wants to...
First, I want to say thank you.
Oh.
Thank you for this opportunity, for collaborating. Go ahead, Dave.
And thank you for wearing blue.
Yeah.
Just going to say, stay tuned. We have 8.5 acres beside our current campus that we're studying to determine the best use of. One of the key elements of Pine's success in the past has been to listen to community needs. So we're going to be embarking on a marketing study soon to determine what best use of the property is. And so stay tuned for a big announcement.
Oh, excellent.
Cool.
Very cool.
And thank you.
Yeah, oh, thank you, Veronica.
Well, I got to thank you guys for everything you do. So, and I want to thank you for tuning in to Goodwill Minnesota's Good News, and I hope we share with you some of the good that is happening in our community.